Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question which says, suppose the demand per month for a commodity is 12, if the price is $15, and 8, if the price is $23, assuming that the demand curve is linear, determine first the demand function, second the average revenue, third the marginal revenue, fourth the actual revenue from selling the 10th item. First of all, let's see what is the demand function. It is given as x is equal to f of p, where this p is the price per unit and x is the number of units demanded at this price P only. Then next we have the revenue function. Which is given as R is equal to R of x is equal to P into x, where again this P is the price per unit, x is the number of units that are being sold, and R is the total revenue collected by selling x units. Next we have the average revenue, which is denoted by AR, and this is the revenue received per unit. So average revenue is equal to the total revenue, which is R, upon the number of units sold, that is x. And we know that R is equal to PX, so we have the average revenue AR is equal to PX upon X, so this comes out to be equal to P. So we can say that average revenue is same as the price per unit. Next we have the marginal revenue, which is denoted by MR, and this is the rate of change of the total revenue with respect to the quantity sold, which is dr by dx. So as R is px, so d by dx of px is MR, and this means that the marginal revenue MR is equal to P plus x into dp by dx. So this is the key idea that we use in this question. Let's now proceed with the solution. In the question, we are given that the demand curve is linear. So we can take, let the linear demand function be P equal to A plus B into X, where this P is the price per unit and X is the number of units demanded, and we are given that the demand per month for a commodity is 12 if the price is $15, that is, if the price of the commodity is $15 per unit, then the commodity demanded are 12 in number, and if the price of the commodity is $23 per unit, then the commodity demanded is 8. So to find out the demand function, we first consider x equal to 12, and in this case the price per unit, that is P, is $15, and when we have x equal to 8, then the price per unit is $23. Now putting the values of x and P, in this equation, say equation 1, we get 15 is equal to A plus 12B, and 23 is equal to A plus 8B. Let this be equation 2 and this be equation 3. Now we need to solve these two equations. So solving equations 2 and 3, we get B as minus 2 and value of A would be equal to 39. So now substituting the values of A and B in equation 1, that is, in this equation, we get P is equal to 39 minus 2x. So this is our demand function. Now in the next part, we need to find out the average revenue, R upon X, that is the revenue upon the number of units sold. So for this, first of all we will find out the revenue function, which is given by R, that is R of X, and this is equal to P into X. So R is equal to P into X, which is 39 minus 2x the whole into x. So we have R is equal to 39x minus 2x square. Now we know that the average revenue AR is equal to total revenue R upon x, which is equal to 39x minus 2x square this whole upon x. So we have average revenue AR is equal to 39 minus 2x. This is the average revenue. Now next we will find the marginal revenue, which is the rate of change of the revenue with respect to the quantity sold. So in the next part, the marginal revenue is equal to MR, and this is equal to DR by DX. Thus MR is equal to D by DX of 39x minus 2x square the whole. So further, this is equal to 39 minus 4x. This is the marginal revenue. Then in the next part, we need to find the actual revenue from selling the 10th item. So the actual revenue from selling the 10th item is equal to the revenue received on selling 10 items minus the revenue received on selling 9 items. As we know that the total revenue is given by the function 39x minus 2x square, so the revenue received on selling 10 items would be given by R at 10, that is by putting the value of x as 10, so 39 into 10 minus 2 into 10 square, which is 100. Now this whole minus the revenue received on selling 9 items, that is we now put the value of x as 9 here, so it is 39 into 9 minus 2 into 9 square, that is 81 the whole. Further, this is equal to 390 minus 200 minus 39 into 9 is 351 minus 2 into 81 is 162 the whole. So further we get this is equal to 390 minus 200 minus 351 plus 162, which is equal to 552 minus 551, and this is equal to 1. Therefore, we can say that the actual revenue received from selling the 10th item is given as $1. So this is the answer for the fourth part of the question. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.